Welcome to Project Fundamentals Intake to Archive. Smartsheet is your foundation for smarter project management. This video is the first in a four-part series where you will learn how to create, manage, and execute a successful project in Smartsheet. In this video, you will learn how to import data, work with custom columns, streamline collaboration with forms, save time with automation, and archive completed tasks for clarity. Let's get started. Imagine you're managing a product launch. Your team manually tracks marketing requests in Google Sheets but wants better automation and collaboration. On the homepage, select Start a New Project. Then select Import. Next, choose your file type, in this case, a Google Sheet. Now we need to map our columns and rows. Select the row that has the column names. Now select the column you want to be the primary column. Then select Import. The imported data serves as the foundation for your project process, with the primary column at its core. The primary column is where you'll list your main tasks or deliverables. You can also add or edit existing columns based on your team's needs. Right-click any existing column and use the menu to make the necessary changes. We will use this sheet to track any new marketing requests related to this project. Let's create a form for stakeholders to submit requests. Select Forms. Select Create Form. The form auto-populates with the columns from the sheet. You can drag them to change the order or remove any you don't need in the form. Let's make the description field a required field. Select the field. In the field settings, toggle on required. Now end users have to fill out this field before they can submit the form. If you add a field to the form, the associated column is added to the sheet. Once the form is edited to your team's needs, there are a few different ways to share it. Select Share Form. You can send the form in an email. Copy the link to the form. Or embed the form on your team's dashboard for easy access. Once the form is active, marketing requests populate directly into your intake sheet. Let's use conditional formatting to highlight high-priority requests automatically. Select the conditional formatting icon. Select Add New Rule. Choose Set Condition. Select Priority. Choose High. Then select OK. Now we can pick the formatting. Select this format. We want these tasks to be easy to spot. Let's highlight them yellow. Now we have to choose how we want the formatting applied. The default setting is to the entire row, but let's adjust that. Select Entire Row. Let's change the settings so only the priority column is highlighted. Select Priority. Then, select OK. You can use the drop-down arrow. To add other conditions, copy, delete, or disable the rule. For now, select OK. Here we can easily and quickly spot our high-priority tasks. Now, let's add a few more conditional formatting rules and add some background colors to help distinguish between columns. Now that our marketing requests are formatted in our intake sheet, let's automate approvals to streamline workflows. Select Automation. Select Create from Scratch. We can name our workflow. We want to send an approval request to the team director when a new row is added. If approved, we want to notify the project manager. If declined, we want to archive the row to a separate sheet. Let's start by making the trigger when a row is added. The request ID will be populated with each form entry, so let's use that for the automation. Select Request ID. Because the request ID is an auto number, any value will work as the trigger. We only need the workflow to run when triggered, so we will leave this setting as is. Now let's select an action. Scroll to find request and approval. Now let's add our director's email address. Now that we have the approval request set, we need to determine what happens if the request is approved or declined. If the request is approved, we want the project manager to be notified so they can adjust the project plan accordingly. Select Add an Action. Select Alert Someone. Add the project manager's email, then you can customize the message if you need. And finally, let's set up the archive workflow in case a request is declined. We'd like to move any rows of data that are declined to our separate archive sheet. Select Add an Action, then scroll to find the Move Rows action. Now we need to select a sheet for the archived data to move to. Find the archived sheet for our project. Save your changes to set up your automation. You can keep track of all of the automations built on your sheet, and you can edit or test them at any time. This wraps up our video on creating an intake workflow. Are you ready to get started creating optimized project plans in Smartsheet? Explore the Project Fundamentals learning track to learn more. Thanks for watching.